The Go Color 7 was one of my favorite 3 e-reading devices for 2025, and you can check out my other two in the video link below. However, this device was not perfect right out of the box. It took me quite a bit of trial and error playing around with the refresh rates and some other configurations to really get a smooth reading experience. So I'm here today to share the settings I ultimately landed on and hopefully save you some time. To start, I'd recommend adjusting the Go Color 7's default color settings so your images and highlights look a little less pale. You can access this by swiping from the upper right hand of your screen and tapping on E-Ink Center. Under color mode, I selected custom, and then I dialed up the dark color enhancement to 70, vivid enhancement I left at 30, and then color brightness I set to 0. Next, I'd recommend adjusting your screen resolution settings, which you can get to by going back to the E-Ink Center and selecting optimize. I left the DPI at 350, I kept bolded fonts off, and then I toggled on eliminate font aliasing, which made my text look slightly crisper. And then I set full refresh to off when switching pages. Under color optimizations, I dialed up the background color to 50, which adds more contrast between the background and text and helped me with readability. Under other colors, I bumped up the icon color all the way up to 250, which adds more saturation to your app icons in the system UI. I also set my cover color all the way down, which led to slightly less ghosting on large, colorful documents, but you may want a little bit more saturation here. And lastly, under other settings, I turned off Stay Active in the background, which will prevent apps from running and using up your battery power when you're not using them. I turned on Force Follow System Orientation, which ensured the reader app interface correctly maps to the Go Color 7 screen size. And then under this section, you can also map these side buttons to different functionalities, but it's really up to personal preference which you choose here. And then lastly, I recommend toggling off the startup animation, which is huge for accessing your apps faster. Returning to the main E-Ink menu, the Go Color 7 comes with a handful of different refresh rates. I personally found the speed refresh rating to be the best setting for me because it made it easy to scroll back and forth between pages without the lag that can make using E-Ink devices like this so frustrating. You can also switch to the normal refresh rate, and you'll notice you get slightly crisper text with less ghosting in between pages, but I personally found that the highlighting experience was more clunky when using normal mode, whereas when I switched back to the speed setting, it was lightning fast and super smooth. I personally would suggest setting your refresh rate to speed to start with, and if you notice any ghosting on your documents, you can quickly clear this by manually refreshing your screen. I just set my refresh rate at the global system level, but you can also set your preferred refresh rate on a per app basis. Getting into reader-specific settings, you can customize your document appearance by tapping on the 3 dots at the bottom of a document and then selecting Appearance Settings. Here you can adjust your page margins and preferred font, and you can also choose if you want to scroll your documents continuously or using a page scroll mode. You can set up your scroll preferences on a per document basis, or you can set it as a global default under more settings. Shortly after I filmed this video, we actually shipped what we call E-Ink mode to this appearance menu, which will be automatically toggled on for all Boox and Daylight devices. When this mode is toggled on, Reader will automatically apply a high contrast color palette and reduce animations to your documents for a smoother reading experience. And lastly, I would recommend installing the Gboard app, which lets you install the split keyboard. Since the Go Color 7 device is a bit wider, I found that the split keyboard made typing much faster and more accurate because I could use 2 hands. That is how I configured my Go Color 7 for the best reading experience. If you have any other questions, feel free to drop them in the comments below. Thanks so much for watching and happy reading!